Disconnect extruder motor cable, nozzle connection cable, X motor cable, X limit switch cable, filament runout detection cable, PTFE tube, etc. Remove screws securing the fixed crossbeam and take off the fixed plate on the lead screw.
Remove screws securing the T-bar nut fixies.
Remove the synchronous pulley from the Z-axis and take off the timing belt. Remove the top crossbeam and slide out the X-axis assembly. Be cautious and support the lead screw on the side of the screen to prevent it from falling. Remove screws from the X motor cover and take off the motor cover. Adjust the nut for the X synchronous belt and remove the screws securing the belt adjustment bracket.
Remove the left and right pulley assemblies of the Z-axis.
Remove the POM wheels from the left and right pulley assemblies of the Z-axis. Use M5/8 screws to secure the brass screw and slider mounting bracket to the front sheet of the Z-axis. Use M5/8 and M3/6 screws to secure the rear sheet to the brass screw and slider mounting bracket. The process is the same for both sides. Install the assembled left and right pulley components on the X-axis profile, ensuring the timing belt is wrapped around the synchronous pulley of the X-axis motor. Check that the timing belt is in the correct position on the other end. Reattach the belt adjustment bracket to the front sheet of the Z-axis.
Reattach the X motor cover to the front sheet of the Z-axis.
Use M3/8 screws and M3T-type screw nuts to fasten them on the Z-axis guide rail. Install one every 1 to 2 holes. Clamp the positioning fixture on the Z-axis profile. Place suitable height auxiliary items. After inserting the lead screw, place the entire X-axis assembly into the Z-axis profile. Insert the guide rail of the Z-axis into the Z-axis profile, and fix the upper end of the guide rail with the positioning fixture.
Tighten the screws securing the Z-axis guide rail.
Use M3/6 screws to fasten the slider mounting bracket to the guide rail slider. Fix the rear sheet of the Z-axis on the lead screw nut. Perform the same operation on both sides.
Remove the positioning fixture from the guide rail.
Reinstall the timing belt and synchronous pulley on the lead screw.
Install the top crossbeam back onto the Z-axis profile.
After placing the fixed plate on the lead screw, secure them with screws. Adjust the horizontal height of the X-axis. This step is crucial. After adjustment, tighten the grub screws on the left and right synchronous pulleys. Move the Z-axis up and down, then tighten the screws in the X-axis direction. Adjust the tension of the X-axis synchronous belt to the appropriate tightness. Insert the extruder motor cable, nozzle connection cable, X motor cable, X limit switch cable, filament runout detection cable, PTFE tube, etc. into their respective positions. The upgrade is complete. After powering on, please perform bed leveling first before starting the print. Thank you.